ولقد يسرنا القرآن للذكر فهل من مدكر.
This is teacher Ismail Zalawi. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. رونك. How are you? This is your plan, inshallah, for this course. Alhamdulillah, for the previous course, we finished memorization of Surah Al-Nasr in a perfect way, alhamdulillah. So I'm so proud of you. Jazakillahu khairan for your efforts. And inshallah, for our memorization for this course will be Surah Al-Masad, inshallah. So I will read it for you now and focus with me, please. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم تبت يدا أبي لهب وتب ما أغنى عنه ماله وما كسب سيصلى نارا ذات لهب وامرأته حمالة الحطب في جيدها حبل من مسد. This is for Surah Al-Masad, and also inshallah we have revised all the surah we memorized before, from Surah Al-Ikhlas to Surah Al-Nasr, inshallah, to avoid any forgetting for the surah we memorized. And let's move to the second part of our course. This is studying of the Arabic, how to recite Quran. Alhamdulillah, we finish all the names of the letters. Then inshallah, we will move to how to read the first sound in Arabic. This is called the Fatha. And the Fatha, this is what mean by Fatha. This is a small slash on the top of any letter. When you see this is small slash on the top of any letter, this is what mean by Fatha. And the Fatha mean, how can we pronounce Fatha correctly? When we see a Fatha, we have to open our mouth. So to pronounce Fatha correctly, you have to open our mouth. And remember, Fatha, this is a short sound. So for example, Ta Fatha, give the sound Ta. Tha Fatha, give the sound Tha, open your mouth. Jim Fatha, give the sound, open your mouth, it will be Ja. We pronounce only the first syllable of the name of the letter and make it with short vowel Fatha. So Jim Fatha will be Ja. Ha Fatha will be Ha. Zay Fatha will be, open your mouth. Yeah, excellent. Za, and so on. This is the first part I want you to focus about. The second part I want you to focus about is something very, very important. What is this? This is when you see the letter Hamza on the top of any letter. If you see the letter Hamza on the top of any letter, this letter is called Hamza, not the other letter. Why? For example, if you see the Hamza on the top of Alif here, this letter is called the Hamza, not Alif. The Alif here is like a chair for Hamza, just to carry Hamza. So if you see Hamza on the top of Alif, this is called Hamza. If you see Ya carry Hamza, Hamza on the top of Ya, what is the name of this letter? It's called Hamza. If you see this one here, Hamza on the top of Wa, what is the name of this one? It's also Hamza, excellent. If you see this shape of letter, this is also called Hamza. So all those shapes is called Hamza. When you see the Hamza on the top of any letter, this is called the Hamza, not the other letter. So Hamza Fatha, give the sound A. Ba Fatha, give the sound Ba. Dal Fatha, give the sound, open your mouth and make it short, Da. Ghain Fatha, give the sound Gha. And so on, inshallah, we will learn how to pronounce all the letters with the short vowel Fatha in a correct way, inshallah. And then we will move, inshallah, after finishing Fatha, with the whole of the letters, we will move to how to join two sounds of Fatha together without any cutting. So for example, Hamza Fatha, Hamza Fatha, Hamza Fatha, give the sound A, then Hamza Fatha A, so A, without any cutting. Ba Fatha, Ba Fatha, Ba Ba. Ta Fatha, Ta, Ta Fatha, Ta, so Ta Ta. And so on, inshallah, we will learn how to join two sounds together and pronouncing them without any cutting, inshallah, to have then and move to how to pronounce a whole word. This is contained short vowel fatha in Arabic, inshallah, without any cutting and so on. So this is your plan. Jazakillahu khairan. See you soon, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
محمد رسول الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله.